What is going on, everybody? It's Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're going to be going over an overall market update, looking at the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and the NASDAQ. And we're also going to be talking about some big news that came out with Apple stock, as well as one trade that I made today in the stock market on the 2nd of January in 2018. But before we do talk about all of these topics, for all you new viewers out there, my name is Stas, and I make videos dealing with swing trading, day trading, long-term investing, and my personal philosophies and strategies when it comes down to investing and trading in the stock market. So for those of you guys that want to learn more about that, feel free to drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram as well as on Twitter, and join our Discord group chat as well as our Facebook group. All of those are linked down below in the description box. So what happened today, guys, in the overall stock market? We saw some news from Apple that is dragging down the NASDAQ futures pretty heavily right now. We're going to talk about that. And we're also just going to look at the, you know, overall technicals of the markets. And let's start off right now with the Dow Jones. So today, you know, we closed the day pretty flat, right? We were up about $18.78 at the close, up about 0.08% on the day. But we noticed that earlier on in the day, the Dow Jones was down, I believe, about 300 points. The futures, since early in the morning, guys, I believe they were selling off, and this headed on early into the market today. We saw that big gap down right here. We can see from the close on, what was that day? Monday, to the low of the day today, we were down about 380, 375 points. And from there, you know, we had a pretty good recovery day, only to close the day, you know, pretty even, right? Break even price from, you know, the close on Monday. So what does this tell me, guys? Well, this tells me, you know, that we're struggling to break above that resistance from the past year. And we could talk about that very quickly here. So we noticed we sold off heavily last year. Well, now it's actually last year officially in 2018, you know, in January. We sold off from 27,000 all the way down to here at about $23,400. And this was, you know, a pretty solid correction. And we noticed that we clearly broke that support at around $23,500 this past December. And now we're struggling to get past that old support, which has now become a new resistance point. So we're struggling to get above there, guys. And, you know, on a technical basis right now, what I think is going to happen tomorrow, especially with this big Apple news that just came out, is I think we're going to get rejected and sell off even more, or just start selling off from these couple of green days that we've had in a row tomorrow, because Apple has a huge impact on the overall market. What Apple reports in terms of sales has a huge impact on the overall economy, the global economy, especially in China as well. And, you know, once we talk about this news that just came out, you'll see exactly why I think we're going to sell off, you know, pretty heavily tomorrow in the overall markets. And that's obviously going to affect, you know, the Dow, the S&P, and it's already affecting the NASDAQ futures here. So if we take a look even closer here, guys, we can see that this 50 SMA has been a very strong resistance, you know, for the Dow Jones over the past couple of months since this big sell-off that we've experienced, you know, since October of 2018. So let's take a look at what's going on in the S&P 500, guys. Very similar situation to the Dow Jones today. We sold off early in the morning. We gapped down from the close on Monday, and then we ended off the day up $3.18, up about 0.13%. And if we take a look you know, at some longer term charts here, we noticed that we've talked about this over the past couple of videos, that the S&P is holding the 180 SMA support here on the 3-year 1-week chart. We're holding that trend, very, very important sign in my personal opinion. And on the 20-year chart, we're holding the overall trend from the recession in 2008, that bottom that we saw in 2008. But if we look a little bit closer here on the 20-day 1-day chart, We're noticing some strong resistance at around $2,500, or rather, that's a strong support at around $2,480 and a strong resistance at around, I would say, about $2,520. So on this 20-day, one-hour chart, guys, keep an eye on the S&P 500 to potentially get rejected on this 180 SMA chart. And, you know, since, again, like Apple, like I said about Apple, guys, affecting the Dow Jones, this is obviously going to affect, you know, the S&P tomorrow as well. So I do expect a sell-off in the S&P if this Apple, you know, if Apple stock stays where it is right now at around $145-ish dollars. And again, we're going to talk about that in a couple of minutes. And let's just take a look at the NASDAQ futures to see how this is already affecting, the sell-off in Apple is already affecting the NASDAQ futures. So if we take a look on this, you know, let's look at a closer time frame chart here so we can see what happened today. So today on the 2nd of January, we noticed that, you know, we sold off from 8:15 p.m. yesterday in these futures. We were at about $6,400. We sold off all the way here to about $6,100 at around 3:40 a.m., you know, about 6 hours before the market opened, 3:40 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Then we started to push up in price here. And the NASDAQ actually had a pretty solid run as well, along with the other indexes here, from around 6190 all the way up to 6400. And then check out this huge red candlestick that came out after hours once we got that news, guys. Literally, we dumped from 6400 all the way down to about 6200. We lost about 180, 200 points there on the NASDAQ. And just like the other futures, guys, you know, or the other indexes rather, I do expect the NASDAQ to continue to sell off tomorrow, especially if Apple continues to sell off heading to the trading day tomorrow. But from a technical perspective here on the NASDAQ, we are at the resistance right now at the 50 SMA, guys. And, you know, if we do end up selling off, we're going to end up breaking these supports, longer term supports here on the NASDAQ from a couple years back. And, you know, that's going to just push us, you know, deeper and deeper into that bear market territory that we are currently in right now in the NASDAQ itself. So let's talk about what happened with Apple very quickly and how this has a huge, you know, effect on the global economy. So I have an article here pulled up, and let's just talk about that very quickly. So Apple just confirmed the stock market's biggest fear. More and more companies are confirming that President Trump's trade war is slowing down the economy. This is something that we've known for the past couple of months. The trade war has been affecting the economy and especially the stock market, and the stock market hates uncertainty, which is exactly what the trade war has been, you know, feeding the investors out there, right? Tons of uncertainty. So on Apple, or on Wednesday, rather, Apple shocked markets when it said revenue in its holiday quarter, which is right now, would miss expectations. This news sent Apple shares down as much as 7%. I think it's even worse now, after hours, and confirmed the market's biggest fear about the global economy, that trade is slowing down businesses around the globe. While we anticipated some challenges in key emerging markets, we did not foresee the magnitude of the economic deceleration, particularly in Greater China, Apple CEO Tim Cook said in a letter to investors published after the market closed on Wednesday. In fact, most of our revenue shortfall to our guidance and over 100% of our year-over-year worldwide revenue decline occurred in Greater China across iPhone, Mac, and iPad. So this just goes to show the impact that we are seeing from this trade war and how weak the Chinese global economy has really, you know, gotten to, right? It's gotten extremely weak, guys, over this past year due to this trade war and all the uncertainty between Trump and the president of China. This is having a huge impact, guys. Apple now expects revenue will total $84 billion in its fiscal first quarter, below its initial guidance for revenue of $89 to $93 billion the company gave Wall Street back in November. So we could potentially see, guys, a $10 billion hit, right? Or a $10 billion miss if Apple's, you know, if Apple brings in $84 billion, guys, and some people were expecting $93 billion, that is a $9-10 billion hit. That's a huge miss for Apple. Very unlike Apple, guys. Obviously, over the past couple of years, Apple has been beating expectations. So the fact that we're, you know, missing expectations by a significant amount, it's not like we're missing expectations by, you know, $1 billion or something. $5 to $10 billion, you know, that's a pretty big miss, and that's going to send the stock down, you know, and the overall markets down. And it's already happening right now, guys, like we saw from the NASDAQ futures, as well as what we're going to look at right now in Apple stock itself. So let's just take a look at the 1 day, 1 minute, so we can see the magnitude of this drop. So we closed the day at 157, guys, pretty flat on the day, you know, really flat, actually, right at break even from where we closed the previous trading day on Monday. And literally, guys, this stock fell like a, you know, like a dynamite, right? It fell like a freaking nail. Take a look at that. 8%, 8.25% to be exact, at its lowest at about 144. And we actually broke the 52-week low on this drop. And right now we're trading at around 146.07. It's still moving as we speak. So just keep an eye on Apple tomorrow, guys. It's going to play out very, very interestingly. It's going to affect the entire market, so just be ready on that. And, you know, we've officially been rejected by the 50 SMA right now. We made a lower low. We broke that 52-week low, like I said. And guys, this is just going to probably drag down, most likely drag down the markets. And Tesla today, I made a video on this earlier today, so go check this video out, the video previously. Tesla had some very bad news today as well. You know, production numbers weren't up to par. They dropped most of, I think, all of their models down by $2,000. So Tesla stock took an 8% hit today as well at its worst. So these are the two biggest news stories today. Definitely in the stock market is Apple, number one for sure. And then Tesla also had some pretty bad news. And again, I uploaded a video talking more about the Tesla situation earlier today. So go check that video out. It's the upload before this one. But let's talk about what I traded today, and let's get into that. So in yesterday's video, I talked about a couple of stocks, and some of them played out according to my plan, and some others didn't, including DWT went completely opposite to what I was planning today. And, you know, JNUG is the one that I actually played earlier on in the day, and I talked about this one in my video yesterday as well. And this is the one successful trade that I did have today. And let's take a look closer. And for those of you guys that don't know, JNUG is a gold-based ETF. It trades based upon /GC. And whenever /GC, guys, the gold futures are going up in price, that's when JNUG is going up in price as well. So just looking at these gold futures really quickly, what I was talking about in yesterday's video is this cup pattern that the gold futures are in on the 180-day 4-hour chart. We were downtrending, we found the bottom, and now we're reversing to the uptrend with the next resistance being at around $1,300. So I honestly think on the shorter term chart here, or rather the 180 chart, not really a short-term chart, but I honestly think we could hit $1,300 and continue to go above that, you know, based off these technicals on the one-year chart. If we break that resistance, guys, you know, that's going to be a good sign to test previous highs at around $1,350, probably around $1,310, $1,320. And, you know, right now, based off this chart, it does seem like we do need a pullback in the gold futures, because we are noticing the RSI is pointing to it being a little bit overbought. So if we do get a pullback, I think we'll get an even better entry point on JNUG, but that's besides the point, right? That's if you're looking to potentially hold JNUG for a couple of days. You know, you should be looking for that pullback right now, in my personal opinion. But how I played it today was a very simple day trade, and we can look at that very quickly here on this 1 day, 1 minute. So very similar to my trade yesterday or the day before in WT or in DWT, this JNUG trade was another gap fill trade. And we saw the margin of profit open from this pre-market high at around 940 all the way down to about 895. And remember, guys, gap fill trades are pretty much when you're looking at stocks or ETFs that have hit a high in the pre-market and that are selling off heading into the market open. And that's exactly what we see here. We hit the high, sold off heading into the market open, opening up that margin of profit. And that at that point, guys, it just becomes a waiting game to see if we find a bottom and we slowly start to go up, uptrend in price to fill that gap. And that's exactly what ended up happening today, guys. I was patient with JNUG. We double topped, or not double topped, rather. We got rejected here. Started to sell off, we made a lower low, and then we had that aggressive push up, and we broke above this 180 SMA here, and this is actually when I ended up taking a position, guys. I got in a little bit late on this one, I'm not going to lie. I did not want to get in here because at this point in time, we were still technically making lower highs, and we already made that lower low, so I didn't want to get in here to only, you know, get rejected by this 50 SMA and then lose my money, right? I wanted to wait and see if we were going to break this resistance first at around 920, and I completely butchered that line, but it doesn't really matter. But I wanted to see a break above this resistance before getting in, and that's exactly what I ended up doing. We got in here at around 925 roughly, waited for that pullback. It played out perfectly, guys. We bounced at about 922 again, added more money at around 930, had a very strong position at around $9.25, I believe, 27 cents, that I ended up just selling off right at around $9 and I believe 45 cents as we pushed up above that pre-market high to pretty much a higher high from the trend that we saw in the previous trading day. And this trade, guys, very, very small. And today's trading day, honestly, guys, I didn't do too well in terms of percentage gain. It was literally from 927 up to about 945. That's literally the trade that I made. Very quick trade, small trade in terms of margin. Made about 1.75 today. My goal is typically around 3, 4, 5% per day. So I missed my goal today, guys. But like I always say, profit is profit, and whatever profits you can take from the market, that is a successful day. So I'm very happy with my day today, guys, of about 1.75%. And at this point, you know, I stopped trading for the day and, you know, just kept my eyes on the market periodically throughout the day. So I want to talk about another one that played out very well today, and that's ticker symbol CRON, the marijuana stock that I talked about in my video yesterday. And this is one that did very well today and really just broke above that resistance on the 50 SMA that we were talking about in yesterday's video. We saw it was up about 8%, 90 cents. And why I was originally on this stock, or looking at this stock rather, was due to the consolidation we saw here on top. I believe it was right on top of this trend line here above the 180 simple moving average. It was making a sort of, you know, cup pattern here, right? It was making a cup pattern, and I was waiting for that pop above here to see if it was going to complete that, right? And if it was going to complete that, I want to see if it's going to wait or hold on top of this 50 SMA now before entering a position. And I know this looks like a cup and handle pattern right now, right? The cup, the handle. So this could potentially be a an interesting spot for CRON, right? I'm not really looking to trade CRON right now because I did miss the move today, but I'm not looking to trade it, you know, in these coming days until we get out of this 1150 roughly resistance that we do see here, because I don't want to get caught in this handle pattern right here. I really want to just, you know, we're in this cup pattern. We're seeing a potential handle. I want to get out of this resistance point, and out of that cup and handle pattern before, you know, getting into CRON potentially, right? And again, I've talked about CRON over the past couple of days. I see potential in CRON up to $13, $14, $15 if we do break out of that resistance that we are at right now. You know, we've seen CRON run to $15 multiple times in the past. We've seen it here roughly like $13, $15 range I'm talking about, right? We saw it here a couple weeks ago, right? And I do see potential in it right now, especially since it's holding a higher low from these previous lows and this holding this trend line very nicely. So I'm keeping an eye on Kron very closely tomorrow, guys. And in general, tomorrow, what I'm going to be doing, guys, in my strategy for tomorrow at this point is to watch the bear ETFs, including DRIP, DWT, TVIX, and SQQQ. These are four ETFs that tend to do very well when the markets are selling off. And like I said, guys, Apple's stock falling today, and the news that, you know, the global economy may be coming to a slowdown, and the numbers of Apple are proving that, right? I think this is going to sell or, send the market down pretty aggressively tomorrow and, you know, potentially over the next couple of days. So we noticed the correlation with the market selling off to these bear ETFs, right? We obviously know that TVIX goes up when the markets are selling off. DRIP tends to go up when the markets are selling off, right? We noticed in the beginning of October, DRIP was a $5 ETF. At the end of December, right, it's a $28 ETF. So this just shows us that this goes up in price when the markets are selling off. They don't necessarily correlate, 100%, right? But typically, they move in the same direction. So we noticed that it sold off pretty big right now. And if Apple does drag the markets down tomorrow, again, nothing is 100%. For all we know, we can see Apple, open up at 155 tomorrow, right? I'm not saying this as, a 100% definite. I'm just really just going over my personal opinion. So if this does end up selling off, guys, I see DRIP doing very well tomorrow, DWT doing very well tomorrow, and pretty much every bear ETF out there. That's my strategy for tomorrow. Just keeping an eye on the bear ETFs, guys, like, LABD is going to do very well if this sells off, DWT, like I said, DRIP, and there's a ton of other ones. And if we look at these market ETFs that I always trade, right, let's take a look at these, TVIX, very well tomorrow if the market sells off, as well as SQQQ. So let me know, guys, what do you think down below in the comment section? What's going to happen tomorrow? Is Apple going to send the market down? I personally think it is. Let me know what you guys think down below in that comment section. So I'll catch you guys in the next video. Please do your own research. Always remember to do your own research when trading and investing in stocks. Do not buy or sell based off of my opinion or anybody else's out there. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you found value in it, feel free to drop a like, leave a comment, subscribe, and follow me on all those other platforms down there if you want to keep in touch with our community. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out.